Sure.
Yeah. So when we're thinking about this, the reason that I'm gauging what you're saying and the reason I'm diving into what you're saying and the reason I want to change your mind about what it is that you're saying is because I think you're coming to an improper conclusion based on bad thinking. And I think that I can assist with that. And so that's why I want the opinion and why it is that you think this. And if all you can say is it's justified via ick, there's no way in the world, because you could justify anything with ick, right? You could justify any discriminatory behavior with ick. You can justify hating women with ick. You could justify hating men with ick. You could justify anything with ick. So that would be improper thinking, wouldn't it?
I don't know, Andrew. I'm. This is, again, just my opinion. What were you going to say?
My question is, so when I sit there and I look at men my age where I'm from, mm-hmm. most of them can't tell their left ass cheek from the right. Mm. Okay? So when I sit there and I say I look at men 30 plus years old because they know what they want. They've been through life. They're ready to settle down. I'm sorry?
How old are you again?
I'm 26.
You're 26. Okay. That's
30, 40, 50 year old men. That's who I tend to look at. Mm-hmm. Right? Because they have their shit together. They know what they want. Men in their 20s, men in their 30s, they don't know what they want typically. It's very, very rare to find that. Mm-hmm. So I don't necessarily agree with your point of they should be closer together. Like I said, women tend to mature significantly quicker than men. Mm. I know a lot of women in their 20s who are ready to settle down, but the men aren't.
I have one question for you. Would you prefer, here's the scenario. So a woman dates a man who's, say she's 21, dates a 35-year-old. Do you, just really quick, do you object to that age gap?
It's getting a little out there, but it's not as bad as 40. Yeah, not as bad as 40.
So let's say he's a good guy. He wants a monogamous relationship, doesn't cheat on her, wants long-term. Or would you prefer to see that woman, say, in the period over the course of 2 years, get kind of strung along by, like, fuck boys her age? Which do you prefer?
I think if the guy is, like, genuinely a good guy and actually mm-hmm. interested in her, like, for more than just her physical looks and her appearance and the fact that she can pop out 20 babies, like, there's actually, like, care for her, then I think that a 35-year-old, 21-year-old, it's pushing it, for my personal opinion. But I think that, to your point, would be a better scenario than her.
Does it change if she's 40?
What do you,
or sorry. It's, excuse me. Does it change if he's 40?
I just wonder why, like, out of all...
No, but, okay, so the question is, in this scenario, he's a good guy, monogamous, wants a long-term relationship with her.
It raises more questions for me.
Right. But would you rather see her in the situation with the older man, who wants to have a long-term monogamous relationship with her, is not going to cheat, going to be loyal, or for her to just be hoeing around and sleep with 20 frat boys her age? Which would you prefer to see?
I mean, I prefer them both to be settled and happy.
That's not the question. That's not the question.
Answer the question. Stage of their life.
There's two options. Which would you prefer to see?
The 21-year-old and the 35-year-old?
Okay, so I changed it to 40. So
okay. I think it's starting to get weird at 40. But
yes,
I do
you've
prefer,
already said that.
I know, but I was in the middle of saying I would prefer to see them both, like, settled and happy. And again, it's a little uncomfortable for me, but I would prefer that for both of them.
Over her sleeping with men
and him,
her age.
But yes. Yeah.
Wait, what do you mean?
Well, because it's really common in these particular red pill settings that, like...
is this a red pill setting?
Come on.
Are you fucking retarded?
There,
so. I'm sorry, what?
There was an option.
Bro,
there.
Dropped the prop.
Well, I didn't know it was going to come out.
Well, I mean, probably shouldn't play with props.
Brian, you don't need to be so rude.
Could I make a comment as soon as...
Like, why would you call me fucking retarded?
Because, I mean, you dropped the prop. It's on the floor now. You haven't done anything to pick it up.
Well, I would, but I'm a little distracted by you calling me fucking retarded.
Yeah, I mean, here's the tone policing again, so... Is this a rage quit?
Like, I'm not rage quitting. You're just so disrespectful. Like, who
you literally. Yes.
Hang on. Listen, hang on. It's been super hostile. Let's finish the combo. You don't want to finish the combo?
I love you, Andrew, but I'm not going to be called fucking retarded.
It was kind of fucking retarded.
It was also insulting the mental illness. And
it was
the,
a little.
I don't want to hear the rage.
Can I make a quick comment?
That's serious with me, girl.
Well. Yeah, hey, it happens.
I can agree with you on that one.
Yo, Desmond, you can't be on your phone right now, man. Are we?
So
we sing
like, "Happy birthday to you."
No,
I'm just kidding.
No. Are we off the topic, serious? Or can I still comment on this?
What happened to that?
Doesn't exist anymore.
We need to start bullying people again.
Bring bullying back.
I know.
Bring bullying back.
Some people need some thicker skin.
What's up?
It's not really
everything makes my eyes roll.
Huh?
I'm gonna tell you right now. You can tell me you hate chicken and I'll be like, well, that's dumb. But that's just my face.
I mean, we need you to leave. We need you to leave. You can't just please be hanging out back there.
I'm putting my shoes on.
Okay.
Unless you want to come back, participate in the panel, you don't. You can still come back, participate in the panel. Come on. I know for sure you've heard way worse than anything that's on this panel.
The minute we all got here, I don't know if he can hear me.
Tell you what, I'll apologize for calling you a retard if you sit back down.
That's fair.
Apologize for
that is fair.
Men mentally ill.
It'll be a genuine apology.
That's fair.
Wait, we can't.
I mean, we were having a good time. It was a good discussion, honestly. I would like to get back to it.
I mean, did she not call you guys mentally ill and disgusting?
Sorry, say that louder.
Did she guys not comment on men being mentally ill and disgusting for that? That was
yeah, but I mean, so what? That's every feminist whoever's on the show. I just take it with a grain of salt at this point.
I'm willing to do an apology. I'll do an apology.
Yeah, but you need a respectful period.
That hair is... yeah, it's just
I don't know that you're willing to do that, Ryan. Like,
weren't you in the military? Like, I'm just confused. Like, isn't this sort of banter? Like, are you really that...
You just really wanted to fucking retard because...
You fucked up our prop! You fucked up the prop!
Right, it's not that big of a deal.
We're arguing different ideas.
Okay, so cool. Cool.
Can I
door dash out? Bro, you're killing it in the tone policing department. So you can sit back down or you can leave. I mean,
yeah. Honestly, sit back down. We can get back to having a good combo. It was getting good. It was getting good.
She said bye.
She already gone.
Yeah. She's exactly gone.
I guess Morgan, we're gonna have you sit in that chair. I guess. Welcome to the panel, Morgan.
Yay. I almost thought. Come on, which one?
Before we wrap this.
Yeah, all right, well, you know,
can I say something
regarding
that, just like an opposite opinion at
sure.
least?
Go
I mean,
ahead.
I was 21 and one of my like most meaningful relationships was with a 42-year-old man, and he was not predatory. He didn't make me do anything I didn't want to do. I felt like I grew with that person more than anyone closer to my age. And I've even dated people younger than me. I've like kind of understood both sides of that aspect, and it really doesn't mean like the age aspect is like the deciding factor of how, like, I don't know. It's not gross unless it's, you know, I mean, we all know what like that level gets to.
Gross people are gross people regardless of age.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And it also
kind
of depends on the state of the woman, whether, you know, when she's 20 and 21, the lifestyle she's lived.
Are they meant?
Yeah. Well, that's the thing too, is you get a lot of people saying that it's gross for a man to want to be an older man to be attracted to a younger woman, but yet there is... very rarely, I feel like, and you talk about women that seek out older men.
If you wouldn't mind on the mic, can you put your mouth in front of the mic itself? Because otherwise, the audio sounds kind of funky on this end.
Can you hear me better? Yeah. I was saying that I feel like I'm not saying it's never talked about, but I feel like it's definitely not as common. Where you hear this talk a lot of basically it's icky and it's gross for older men to be attracted or seek out younger women, but yet it's not as talked about where you get younger women seeking out older men for their resources, and because let's be honest, that's usually why they're seeking out older men. Because they're more established, they're more
That's like a majority.
Somebody says her mic is.
I'm not saying there's anything
they're
wrong.
Saying her mic is not on.
Mine or hers?
Mine. Yeah, there's something seriously wrong with the audio there.
With mine?
With just your mic specifically.
Did she pull that down?
What it sounds like, Brian, is it sounds like she's kind of underwater a little bit.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, that sounds way better.
Better?
It's her hands.
It might have been me touching.
No, now it's back. Now it's back. It's just that one mic.
I don't know. Do you
want me to
use
bro.
What do you want me to do?
I still think we need to talk about the retard thing.
maybe you can switch seats with that way you got her mic. I don't know.
I don't think switching wouldn't. That doesn't make sense.
If she switched with Helmet Girl. Then, because Helmet Girl, you know what I mean? Then she has the mic. That's all I'm saying.
Can you hear me now, Andrew?
Well, I gave her mine. She has a name, Andrew.
Yeah.
I gave her mine.
Oh, I'm sorry. Are you guys wearing name badges?
No.
Like, how many names should I remember? Okay, so here's what I'll do from now on. It'll be Tiffany 1, Tiffany 2, Tiffany 3, Tiffany 4, Tiffany 5. Yeah, how about we just do it? Would that make you feel better?
I want to be Brittany.
Wait, what do you want me to do?
$200. I was drinking milk from a fresh bowl of cereal that I happened to spill on my shirt. I called myself a retardant and then proceeded to walk out on myself because I was so offended. Now that is meta.
That is pretty meta.
Good for him.
Quick little thing though, is the same thing like apply to like older women that go for younger men? That seems pretty like normalized out.
And also calling men mentally ill and then getting called retardants, but you just called all men mentally ill.
Whoa, that's a really good point. So she called all men retardants.
Ill.
She called.
But you got called retarded.
She called all men retarded. But I call her retarded. She's offended.
What the fuck?
That's fucking good catch. Good catch. Yeah, what's up? What's up? High five for that. Boom.
She said it like 20 minutes ago.
So you guys. Okay, so every man's mentally retarded, but she's not. And that is very unrespectful. Okay.
I think she was digging. I think she was looking.
She wanted that.
She was looking for just any pretext or justification to leave.
No, that's what I was kind of getting at with the fact that when I said women like to not be wrong, that might have not been the best verbiage of it, but... I feel like you get a lot, and I feel like it's more common in women than it is men, where they don't like to admit.
Wait, so a bunch of people are saying the mics are totally scuffed.
Okay,
all of them.
Mics are on.
Because we switched.
Audio, no mics
I
are on.
Hers.
I'm listening.
Check.
Unless we're getting trolled, in the chat.
No, you're not getting trolled. I'm hearing it.
What's up?
I mean, I'm hearing it for sure. Hear it on White Blouse's mic, and then I hear it on your mic, and then everybody else's mic seems to be fine. It's bizarre.
Maybe.
Because we even switched mics. Yeah, her my mic.
Yeah, I know. And it's still like, I don't know why.
You know what? I think we just need to fucking put back in the other audio mixer. It's going to take 2 minutes to do it, but...
Party.
My only concern is if we unplug it, then it's just like...
Gonna shut down the podcast?
We lose audio completely.
Intermission?
Well, I mean, if the viewers know in advance...
Can I get a burrito?
I don't know what changes you're making. I don't know what changes you're making, but I think it's worse. People are saying it's worse now. Andrew, is it worse now?
No. It goes from bad to perfect to bad to perfect to bad to perfect.
Like in and out.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's maybe depending on like.
Okay, I have to make a decision on this. We're gonna have to unplug everything and just go back to the other mixer.
Sweet.
So what that means is
a champagne pop.
Champagne pop.
Let's do it.
So hold on.
They all want a champagne pop, guys.
We brought a bottle of wine, I think.
Let me think about how exactly I want
to
do this.
I gave it to Brian already.
I'm We might even have to restart the stream. At this point, the audio has been so frustrating, which is, you know what? I blame the audio for my outburst.